Let's now look at the solution for part one of this quiz, which is asking when do these four instructions dispatch and write their results. We will do that one instruction at a time. The load is issued in cycle one. It doesn't have any dependencies, but we know that it cannot dispatch in the same cycle when it's issued, so it will dispatch in cycle two. The load takes one cycle to do, so it will write its result in the very next cycle. The multiplication instruction is issued in cycle 2. It will dispatch in cycle 3 or later because it cannot issue and then dispatch in cycle 2. It will dispatch either in cycle 3 or whenever its operands become available. And because this multiply instruction doesn't depend on the load here, it uses F0 and F1, and the load produces F6, that means that this instruction has all the operands ready as soon as it issues, so it can dispatch in cycle 3. It couldn't issue and then dispatch in cycle 2 because of the same thing. Issue and then dispatch in this processor is not allowed. The multiplication takes 5 cycles to do, so if it dispatches in cycle 3 to execute, it's going to be broadcasting its result in cycle 8. The add here is issued in cycle 3. So again, it cannot dispatch in the same cycle, but it could dispatch in cycle 4 if all of its operands are available in that cycle. However, it needs F2 and F6. These are produced by load and multiply here. So actually, it will not be able to dispatch in cycle 4 because the multiply result is only available in cycle 8. So what is going to happen to this instruction is it's going to wait and capture its result in cycle 8, and then it cannot capture and then dispatch in the same cycle, so it will dispatch in the very next cycle, which is cycle 9. Because this is an add and has a latency of 1 cycle, it will write its result in cycle 10. For this add here, it issues in cycle 4. It becomes eligible for dispatch in cycle 5 if its operands are ready, but they're not. It needs the F2 produced by the multiplication and the F6 produced by this add. That means that it will capture its last missing operand at the later of these two cycles, which is cycle 10. So in cycle 10, this instruction captures its last missing operand, which is F6, and then it cannot dispatch in that same cycle because of this, so it dispatches in cycle 11 and finishes in cycle 12. And this completes the first part of the quiz.